didn't have to go outside for about 30 seconds, but in that time that I'm out there, I already started sweating, man.
It was pouring in LA this morning, pouring.
Really?
Yeah, Manny went to run, and it was like a storm.
Oh, man.
I talked to a lot of people who fought Manny Pacquiao. You fought Manny Pacquiao as well, of course.
Yeah.
But Brandon Rios said Manny wins.
Manny wins.
Shane Mosley said Manny wins. Chris Algieri was leaning towards Manny. Tim Bradley is the only Pacquiao opponent that picked Keith Thurman. Jesse Vargas, you fought Manny Pacquiao. What do you think?
I think Manny wins.
Why?
Just pure on his pure experience. And I think that's why he wins. His speed, even though there's going to be a very soon, there's going to come a time and a point where his age is going to show. I'd say no later than 2020.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to be interesting. But I don't know when. I don't know when it is.
How much is it? Real set?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. 32.35.
There you go, sir. Actually, you know what? I'm using my business card.
Okay.
Yeah. But yes, you know, the thing about fighters at that age is that you never know when the age hits them. It would be all of a sudden. I don't think it might not be for this one. Possibly for the next one or maybe 2020.
Brandon Rios told me that Manny Pacquiao had 8 hands in the ring against him. One of the sparring partners this week said 10 hands. When you were in there with Manny, how many Mannys were in the ring with you that night? Was it one? Was it two? Was it three?
It was one Manny, but just very high velocity.
Punches and bunches,
but just his speed was on another level. And, you know, he's jumping back and forth, and, you know, it's just hard to find him.
Jesse, you adjust to any style. We've seen you.
Yeah, but he was extremely fast. But you know what? It helped me as with my learning experience. You know,
TV ready.
There we go.
That's it. Now he looks official.
This gentleman here. Thank you very much.
Have a good time.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Have a nice day.
You got it.
And nice to meet you.
Yes, nice to meet
good
you.
Good advice. She helped out.
Oh,
yeah. It looks better?
Most definitely.
You look official.
Yeah,
counselor,
we're ready now, man.
Objection.
That's right. Thank you.
So let me ask you this.
Yes.
A lot of people, like both Robert Garcia and Chris Algieri, told me the biggest problem about Manny is the preparation. You can't get a Lomachenko as a sparring partner.
Yeah, yeah. That's
how do you prepare for it, Jesse? How did you prepare for Manny?
You have to get light sparring partners that are extremely fast. And you might even have to get, you know, something I should have done is just got lighter guys. Maybe fighters that were 126, 130 pounds.
You got one.
Just so that I can get that speed.
Yeah,
you know, because that's the speed that he maintains as a fighter of 126 pounds. But with that speed, but with a constant rhythm, I'd say about Manny. You know, it's a constant rhythm. He has a very good endurance. And the guy is phenomenal, man. I mean, he's 41. He's still doing it. He's got to get credit.
He's up there with the argument of maybe the best fighter ever. A division champion has achieved everything.
World champion at 41 years old.
That's true. And he's fighting a very tough Keith Thurman. Keith Thurman is a very tough opponent.
I agree.
Thank you.
I agree, but I don't think he has the experience that Manny has. I think that's going to be his downfall.
That's going to be the hook.
Because Jacinto fought a good fight with Keith Thurman. Great fight.
Yeah.
Congratulations to him.
That was a good... But Thurman was smart and was able to pull off the fight. Survive.
Not
everybody's good boxing IQ.
Are you with Jacinto or are you with Keith Thurman?
No, I'm just being... I like Jacinto. Jacinto's the homie. And he did his job. He almost pulled it off. He came so close in the seventh round. Another ref would have stopped the fight. But it's boxing, but I'm saying Keith was able to survive.
Agree.
And that's what happened.
Mm-hmm.
But
this is where the fight is going to take place tonight.
This is the quiet before the storm, as I would call it.
Exactly.
And you know, Andy Ruiz may be here tonight. I went to see him this morning.
He will
press
be here
conference.
Tonight. He will be.
He will be here. That's exciting. You going to interview him?
He might be here a little late. Maybe.
He's talking about a rematch. What do you think about his rematch? You actually just, you're one of the few people that said he was going to win. You called it.
I said it could happen, but it did.
I know, but you're, now everybody says they called it. You actually did.